Hi, I'm John Paul.
And I'm Olivia.
And we're bringing you the news from the 007 studio. Tomorrow, we'll celebrate an all-school mass in the gym during WIN. It's Ash Wednesday, so in addition to the normal mass, we'll also receive ashes to mark the beginning of Lent. We'll be on an adjusted bell schedule. Mass will run through 9:30 through 11 a.m. to allow more time for ashes. There will also be incense at this mass. Ash Wednesday marks the start of our 40-day Lenten journey. Lent is a penitential season in the Catholic Church. It is a time for us to come to know God in new and deeper ways through prayer, fasting, and almsgiving. Lent helps us declutter our lives and focus on what is really important, our relationship with God. We are inviting you to participate in the Scecina's one-on-one challenge. Number one, what is one thing you are going to give up for Lent? People choose to give up different things, like sweets or soda. You could also give up TV or your favorite video game. Just be sure to make it something meaningful and sacrificial. Giving up homework or chores doesn't work for this. Number two, what is one thing you are going to start doing this Lent? What virtuous habit can you develop? Maybe you know it would be good to dedicate time to prayer every day. Maybe you should spend more time doing homework. Maybe you can make an effort to compliment at least one person each day. And number three, what is one sin or one category of sin that is most affecting your life that you want to focus on this Lent? In other words, what is keeping you from a life-giving relationship with Jesus, His church, and the important people in your life? Maybe you've been prone to gossiping about others. Maybe you've been one who spreads hate in person or online. We all tend to struggle in at least one area. So the point of this is to identify it and work to address it. On Thursday, during WIN, we'll begin the Scecina's one-on-one challenge. Your WIN teachers will guide you through it. We'll also check in throughout this Lenten journey to help support each other. Now it's Olivia for today's clubs.
Thanks, JP. The STEM Club will meet today after school in room 5. Contact Mrs. Smith with any questions. The Chess Club will also meet today after school in the art room. Contact Ms. Quigley with any questions. The Rock and Jazz Fans will meet today in the music room. Contact Mr. Hall with any questions. In other club news, Natalie Darzentas qualified for the state archery competition on March 9th. Natalie earned a score of 275 out of 300 during the state qualifier tournament. She took first in the female high school division. Now back to JP for more news.
Thanks, Olivia. Don't forget, Scecina offers several scholarship opportunities for returning students. Check out the Returning Student Scholarship page on the school website under Academics, Current Student Scholarships. All scholarship applications are due to Ms. Millard in the President's office by next Monday. Remember, service hours are due March 1st by 2:30 p.m. That's in just 3 weeks. For any students who still need service hours, there are potentially up to 10 hours available for helping with Club 53. This is Scecina's biggest fundraising event, and it is held in the gym in April. If you have interest in setting up and tearing down for Club 53, please contact Matthew Lemming at mlemming@scecina.org for more information. If you sign up, you will still count for service hours, even though the event won't have happened yet. Now back to Livy for today's sports and more news.
Thanks, JP. Tonight, the boys' basketball teams will play at Roncalli, with JV starting at 6 and varsity taking the court at 7:30. Good luck, Crusaders. In other sports news, the baseball team is hosting its annual fish fry fundraiser for Ash Wednesday from 4:30 to 8 p.m. in the cafeteria. Tickets cost $7 and all proceeds support the baseball team. February is Black History Month, and we're going to test you with a bit of trivia. Which of the following became the first African American to host a TV show? Was it A, Arsenio Hall, B, Della Reese, C, Oprah Winfrey, or D, Nat King Cole? All of these hosted a TV show at some point, but the first was Nat King Cole. The famous jazz singer and pianist hosted NBC The Nat King Cole Show for one season during 1956 and 57. Unfortunately, few advertisers were willing to be connected with a black entertainer at the time, so NBC canceled the show. Cole went on to have a great success as a concert performer in the late 50s and 60s. In addition to his musical talents, he also acted in several movies. Now it's time for our verse of the day. This one is from Matthew chapter 6, verses 16 through 18. It says, "And when you fast, do not look gloomy like the hypocrites, but when you fast, anoint your head and wash your face, that your fasting may not be seen by others, but by your Father who is in secret. And your Father who sees in secret will reward you."
So why wouldn't we want people to know we're fasting? Isn't that a good thing?
It is a good thing, but if we complain about it or we boast about it, it loses the power. The point is to humbly give up something in order to grow closer with God.
So we shouldn't go around complaining about what we choose to give up for Lent?
No. Jesus said to not make it known and act normal, and God will know what we are doing.
That's a good point. Now let's see who is celebrating a birthday.
Happy birthday. Yoo-hoo. Oh yeah.
Enjoy your day, Crusaders. Now for our lunch menu. Today we're having chicken and cheese taquitos with corn. For Ash Wednesday, it'll be cheese pizza, tuna salad, egg salad, or a fish sandwich. Please remember that all menu items are subject to change based on availability. In our latest RG poll of the week, we want to know who put on the best Super Bowl halftime show ever. The poll is up in Canvas, so cast your vote by Thursday night and we'll air the results in Friday's show.
I think my favorite one was when Coldplay brought out Bruno Mars and Beyonce. Did you have a favorite?
No. I've never actually seen a halftime show.
Really?
No, that was just never something that my family did. But did you know that Failing Forward crew hit up a Chinese buffet last Friday?
No. Did they make an episode or something?
Not exactly, but they did make a vlog.
Oh, well, let's check it out, I guess.
All right, here it is.
Hi, guys. It's Tamina. She's so cute. Here, CC. So we're here, birthday buffet day. Not on the 8th day.
Birthday buffet day, but not on the 8th day.
I'm gonna go around and everyone's gonna give their review. Give it 1 through 10.
10 out of 10.
My name's Jordy. Senior here at Scecina High School. And I got like a lemonade.
This might not be the best.
And overall, the food is just like a 7.5. 8, 10.
The food is really great here.
Matthew Hess.
It is birthday. What a happy man. Happy birthday. Yeah.
18. 132 pounds. Okay. 5'8.5. Scecina Memorial High School.
Hey, what's the address?
Offensive lineman. My social security is 3. Right now we got
teriyaki chicken.
Yeah, red.
Red 40.
I'm passing the phone to someone who killed.
They do it better in Germany.
We're at Super China Buffet. On plate number 2. Everyone else is on plate 1.
Just because they don't have Diet Coke.
Oh no.
I'll give it a 7 out of 10.
I need the dough.
Hey everybody, dessert acquired. I already messed up my oranges, so.
Because it'll be like, you'll have plenty of luck in the future.
Tamina thinks this one's really good.
10 out of 10.
I haven't gotten dessert, but I will soon, you know.
Go get it out.
Very soon.
There's their dessert.
They said the cookie's on fire.
Yeah, it doesn't really taste like coffee because it doesn't taste like anything.
Is this your dessert?
Yeah.
I can drive.
It looks like they had fun.
Yeah, and at least this time they weren't trying to take our jobs.
True.
Well, that's it for today's Red and Gold Show.
Stay classy.
And give that little extra.
Unforgettable in every way. And forevermore. That's how you stay.